So cutting this Haas skateboard would have been great on, say, a UMC 750 5-axis machine. We didn't have one of those available. We were doing this on a VF5 SS, straight 3-axis machine. But I actually utilized some multi-axis functionality in Mastercam to cut this part. Multi-axis unified, for instance, what a great feature in Mastercam to be able to do some of this complex 3D surfacing on that 3-axis machine. Makes programming it so simple, and then you've got added functionality like collision control, and just to use it in 3-axis, you set your tool axis control to 3-axis. So let's look at how I did this outside fillet utilizing multi-axis unified on a 3-axis machine. So to start, I'm just gonna go into the parameters here and kind of walk you through what I did with this toolpath. And some of the color coding now that we do on the graphic screen really helps me explain this, right? So you can see the first curve, I'm using unified and I'm using morph. And the first curve is blue. So I go and chain the whole outer edge of this fillet. Now for the second curve, as you would expect, I chain the lower curve of that fillet all the way around. Right? I'm going to be morphing between these two curves to get a nice cut pattern. My step over is 15 thousandths. Now, what's different about this with a 5-axis machine versus the 3-axis that we're utilizing is I don't really have any options for tool axis control. If I'm gonna run this on a 3-axis machine, I am forced to use the output format of 3-axis and use the WCSZ. It's the only option for a 3-axis machine since your tool is fixed in a 3-axis direction. The other feature that I've got inside of Mastercam Unify that's super helpful that I really don't have a comparable option inside of the 3D toolpath is collision control. I can do some really neat things with collision control in Multiaxis Unified. Now, in some instances, coming around this top edge, I could experience some gouging as the tool tries to wrap around. With Mastercam Unified, I can take that collision control and compensate this out. I'll retract the tool away from origin around that outside edge, and I end up with a really spectacular tool path here. If we backplot this, you'll see what I'm talking about. Right around this outer edge here, we snap to this point. So this collision control allows me to offset that tool away from the surface, not gouge any of the part, and I get such a nice, even step over, walking up over that fillet, and realistically, the end result here, the results speak for themselves. Just a fantastic finish, and it was really easy to program. I'm not going through and selecting check surfaces, or trying to massage 3D toolpaths to do something that might be more challenging.